In the latest wave of closures, a major bank has abruptly announced it's shutting all its branches for good. But as customers are forced to go online, should banks be allowed to prune their branches?
I'm not a computer person, and if it wasn't for my son and daughter, I don't know what I'd do.
And the bank's making a decision just to abandon these customers.
Bankwest. It's been handling the cash of the people of WA for almost 130 years. And this is its slogan.
At Bankwest, it's bankless from now on.
Less is right. The state's oldest lender announcing it's going online only from October.
That's bank stuff.
The plan? 45 branches will be shut down. The remaining 15 converted to Commonwealth Bank, which owns Bankwest. Although CBA has only committed to keep regional branches open until 2026.
Most of the older people don't have access to digital banking.
Well, I feel a lot safer going in and doing something person to person than doing it online.
Bankwest says customers will still be able to carry out many everyday banking and cash transactions at more than 350 local post offices in WA, promising to support the 2,000 customers hit hardest.
We'll have a bespoke solution for those customers where bankers will contact them one-to-one with solutions.
Once you get out of cities, connectivity is a real issue. We've heard stories of people having to do their banking at midnight and 1 a.m. in the morning so that they don't lose that connection.
But Bankwest says keeping the branches open no longer makes sense. Fewer than 2% of its customers visit a branch regularly, 97% of transactions taking place online.
Yeah, I can't remember where the last time I went into a bank. I just have an app on my phone.
The move comes amid a Senate inquiry into the impact of a swathe of recent bank branch closures in regional areas.
Small business in particular is severely affected because everybody's got to go to another town to actually carry out their banking, so they do their shopping, get their haircuts. The smaller communities actually wither on the vine.
So are disappearing bank branches just a sign of the times, or is it putting WA communities at risk?
We've got nowhere to do our banking.
Perth Lord Mayor Basil Zempilas is watching this unfold. Basil, how would you describe the way people are feeling in WA about this?
It's disappointing, particularly for the elderly customers who rely on going into the banks. And it's another little piece of Western Australian history that we're being forced to say goodbye to.
Basil, you talk about the elderly being hit hard there. What other communities will suffer from this?
Well, clearly some of our regional centres that rely on the infrastructure and the other community services that the local bank branches provide. Bankwest for some time now has been owned by the Commonwealth Bank. In a way, this is probably a move to rationalise branches, and instead of having a Commonwealth Bank branch and a couple of doors up, having a Bankwest Bank branch. They've taken the opportunity to rationalise, if you like. But nonetheless, for those people who bank with Bankwest, have done so for a long time, have brought their kids through on that journey, it now means they can only bank on the digital platforms. And that is not what they signed up for.
So, Basil, Bankwest have said 97% of transactions take place online. So does that wash as an excuse to close all these branches?
Well, I think it makes some commercial sense, but there'd be lots of us that would argue against any more commercial sense for the major banks. And as I said, they're owned by the CBA. The profits are extraordinary, and you would have thought to look after those customers, particularly ones who, in the elderly's case, have been with them for their whole lives, it might have made sense that we just hang on a little bit longer. For most of them, they will be able to be provided with alternative services so they can still enter a physical branch if required. It won't be Bankwest, it'll be Commonwealth. They'll be able to get through, but we know that sort of disorientation isn't the kindest thing for elderly customers. So for them, it's particularly tough.
Yeah, we all know that physical banking is a very different experience, of course. I'd love to know, when was the last time you were in a local bank branch?
Ooh. Yeah, look, I accept. I mean, I do most of my banking, obviously, online now, and I know that a fair chunk of the cohort watching will also do all of their banking online. But there are times when either you've got to sort out a blue or there's money not in your account that you thought had to be there. Mm. You've got two choices, haven't you? You can wait online forever on the phone, or you can just walk in and speak to somebody. And I think it's that being able to speak to somebody that people will really miss. And, of course, when we end up with a truckload of coins, that at some point we want to get changed into notes so that we don't have to carry the coins around.
Very
Where
true.
Are we going to do that now?
Basil, thanks so much for your time.
Anytime, guys. Thank you.
Oh, yeah,
it's very true. You know, I spend a lot of time in rural and regional communities, you know, out west in the Red Centre, and it seems like in a small town, I'm talking a really small town, the staple is the bank, the post office, the pub, you know, and you know everyone. You know the people in the bank, you know the people in the post office. It's kind of odd that we're having this huge shift. I mean, 2026, Commonwealth's going to start shutting all that down regionally.
Well, they might. They've just overly committed that far, so we'll see. But the thing that only just occurred to me, actually, just during that story, is we're also, you know, every second week we're doing a story about online scamming.
Yeah.
And so it feels kind of weird, like we're being forced to go online to the one place where the scams are getting so good that we won't be able to spot them.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like it's
And there's
all
no, there's no, like, fail-safe to protect us against that yet. It's like there's so many scams and they just keep on going. So it's like the one way to do that would be to find someone in real life.
Yes.
But you can't.
No. Yeah. It's, I don't
you
know.
You can't at all.